Good morning children, Sai Ram. Children, welcome you all in this biology video in which we are having our chapter number 15, Improvement in Food Resources. And today I am going to finish all the topics of this chapter. The topics which I am taking today, they are storage of grains and about animal husbandry I will discuss. Children, I want to tell you one more thing, that in these videos, in biology videos, I am providing you notes also. So the notes which I am writing here in these videos, those notes you have to write down in your FAIR notebook. You just complete all your notes in your FAIR notebook, and after completing all your work, I will provide you the PDF in which you will be having your exercise question answers. So be ready with your complete work in biology also. Okay, let's start with the topic. So the first topic we are discussing here, that is storage of grains. Children, you must be knowing that most crops are harvested only once a year. They are available in plenty during a selective season. For getting seasonal foods regularly throughout the year, they are stored in safe storage. You can see here, this is granaries where harvested crop is stored. They are stored in gunny bags in these granaries. There are some factors which are responsible for storage losses. These factors are biotic factors like insects, rodents like squirrel, rats, birds like sparrow, pigeon, crow, fungi, mites and bacteria. The abiotic factors are temperature, moisture, humidity, etc. You can see here, these are the insects which can harm the harvested crop. It causes poor quality, loss in weight, poor germinability, discoloration of produce, etc. These factors can be controlled by proper treatment and systematic management of warehouses. Now, how can we control all these storage losses? Preventive and control measures. Drying. The first method is drying. The harvested food grains should be dried by spreading. They must be allowed to keep cool down to the room temperature before storing. Second one is cleaning. The grains should be properly cleaned in gunny bags before keeping in godowns or stores. Next is safe and proper storage. Godowns, warehouses and stores should be cleaned, dried and repaired. And the next method is chemical control. The pesticide solution should be sprayed over the gunny bags. The pesticides like BHC, malathion and pyrethrum can be sprayed. Fumigation can also be done. The pesticides which can destroy insects by forming toxic fumes are called fumigants, and this process is called fumigation. Ammonium phosphate, methyl bromide and EDB are used as fumigants. Now the next topic is animal husbandry. Animal husbandry is the scientific management of animal livestock. It includes various aspects as feeding, breeding and disease control. Animal based farming includes cattle, goat, sheep, poultry and fish farming. It fulfills the demand of milk, meat and eggs. Now, first I am discussing about cattle farming. Cattle farming is done for two purposes, milk and draught labor like cow, buffalo, etc. Children, here draught labor means the animals like buffalo, bull we are using in agriculture practices. They are helping in these agriculture practices. Are reared, cow, buffalo, etc. reared for milk and draught labor for agricultural work. They are mainly two species of reared cattles, Bos indicus, that is cow, and Bos bubalis, that is buffalo. You can see here, it is cattle farming where cows are kept. Now, exotic breeds of cows like Jersey, Brown Swiss are reared for extended lactation. The Indian breeds like Red Sindhi, Sahiwal and Gir show excellent resistance to diseases. They are good milk yielder also. The breeds of buffaloes with high yield of milk are Murrah, Mehsana and Surti. Now the next topic is poultry farming. It refers to rearing of chicken or poles for the production of egg and chicken meat. Asil, Yakub, Nuri are the examples of the Indian varieties of poultry. The exotic breeds are White Leghorn, Rhode Island Red. Now children, next is layers and broilers. Sometimes we are asking you the difference between layers and broilers. So here I am writing it here. Layers are egg laying birds and broilers are reared for meat. You can see here, it's a poultry farming where chicks or chickens are kept. Next one is fishery. Fisheries are the establishments connected with capture, preservation, exploitation and utilization of various type of fishes, prawns, crabs, oysters, etc. All these are good source of proteins. Marine fishery, it deals with fishing in the oceans and seas. And the examples of this fishery are prawns, tuna, etc. Children, here you can see fishes. There are so many fishes you can see. All these are fishes. And how they are kept? They are kept with this rice crop. Because rice crop, it needs a lot of water. So in this water, they can keep fishes also. Next is inland fishery. It deals with the fishing in the rivers, lakes, ponds and tanks. Examples are rohu, katlas, grass carp, etc. Fish culture is sometimes done in combination with the rice crop so that fish are grown in the water in the paddy field. Here you have seen this picture. Now is it clear? Now the next one is beekeeping. It is also called apiculture. It is the rearing of bees for the production of honey and wax. Some of the local varieties reared in India are Apis mellifera, Apis dorsata, Apis serena, etc. Apis dorsata is also known as rock bee, is also an indigenous variety. The Italian bee variety like Apis mellifera has high honey collection property. So you can see here, this is a picture which is showing beekeeping, okay, apiculture. Now, after finishing all these topics, I am just giving you a home assignment in which you are having questions. Name two exotic breeds of cow. What do you mean by apiculture? Name two pesticides. Define animal husbandry. Name the honeybee variety which has the high honey collection capacity. In this way, I am finishing this video, and with this video, our chapter is also finished. Now I will provide you the PDF of question answers that you can write down after writing these notes. So after writing all these notes, you have to write down exercise question answers, which I will provide you soon. Thank you, Sairam.